Welcome to the RGS News Show. I'm Avery Parker.
And I'm Ryder Altman. And Liam Frank has today's weather report. At this time, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Fourth and fifth grade elementary course rehearsals will take place tomorrow morning at 7 a.m.
Get your dance shoes ready. The RGS PTA will host an annual spring dance in the middle school gym this Friday from 6 to 8 p.m. This is not a drop-off event. All children with a ticket must be accompanied by an adult.
Tickets are $20 for one parent and one student. Tickets can be purchased for additional students for the cost of $5 each. Purchase tickets online at rgspta.org. Food trucks will be available at the event.
Today's lunch menu includes classic grilled cheese sandwich, pit beef grilled cheese, salad bar, and fresh fruit.
Trigger Nichols is a long-distance track runner for the Fountain Inn High School JV team. Running can increase life expectancy for up to 12 years. He has been running on the team for about 2 years. Track has brought him many new friends and experiences. Track was one of the best decisions he's ever made.
What's his track?
I love being able to run with my friends and talk with them as we run, and I really like the team that we have here.
And what's your current PR for the mile time?
My current 1600 meter time for the mile is 5:37.
Thanks, Trigger.
And now for today's segment honoring African Americans, 8th grade students on the Washington, D.C. field trip visited the National Museum of African American History.
The museum is a Smithsonian Institution museum located on the National Mall in Washington, D.C. in the United States. It was established in 2003 and opened its permanent home in 2016 with a ceremony led by President Barack Obama.
And now for Mom for Monday, we leave you with a few grammar raps from 6th grade.
Yo, I'ma teach you about semicolons, colons, ton, and conjunctions too. All the things I'm gonna teach you, like colons. Colons link clauses together, make them feel like birds of a feather. Now let's talk about semicolons. Looks like the bottom of a beer that got stolen, and a comma went and took its place. I'ma show you a new conjunction. Now if you don't know what they are, you are a buffoon for nor but yet. So these are conjunctions that you gotta know. Thank you for your time, but it's time that I got
a subject and a verb make a clause. In fact, you don't even need a pause. Now if you find a pause, use a semicolon. Really help out my friend named Nolan. And now if you need a link it, you can also sync it. Another way to pause is to use a comma. Don't need to start drama. Now some clauses are independent. You don't need to get offended. A lot of people use a colon. In fact, most of colon. In the end. To end the sentence, use a period. My haters are furious. Now, to connect clauses, need a conjunction. Without it, the sentence won't function. Some stuff is important you need to emphasize. My haters need to apologize. Now, to understand, you really need to illustrate. Now, you need to appreciate. You really need to make stuff difficult with the independent clause. Now, give us a round of applause.
Yeah, this one right here goes out to all the babies, mamas, 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 baby mamas, mamas.